There are no wrong roads to anywhere. There's no accidents. As we go along, there are course corrections that we can make. Every experience that we have in our life is there to teach us something.
Join spiritual teacher and author Dr. Wayne Dyer for an intimate conversation as he returns to PBS to offer stories of his own life journey and share his deeply held beliefs.
I want to step back from my life because I know that there have been forces or powers or some kind of energy that has been impacting me throughout my entire life.
Learn the 5 key principles that have guided Dr. Dyer through private challenges and public success, and which he now makes available to you.
Your dreams, your imaginations, be fearless with them and let success chase you, and it will.
Watch Dr. Wayne Dyer, I Can See Clearly Now.
I've created a program to help you step back from your life and become aware of a beautiful observation. Think of our lives as tapestries set at our birth. And yet, our life tapestries are ultimately designed by all the choices we have made, we are making, and we will make. These choices and actions we take are what weave the threads together. As I share my life stories with you, you'll learn about the sacred ladder and the 5 rungs which have been the basis for making every important decision in my own life. It's my hope that you'll hear the echoes of your own life stories and will find that climbing this ladder will help you to see that your life's tapestry much more clearly now. The first rung of the sacred ladder is the quality of willingness. As you watch, ask yourself this: are you willing to step onto that first rung to look at the tapestry of your life choices and embrace all the consequences? Are you willing to accept that everything has a purpose, even if you don't understand it at the time? So join me now on stage as we learn what it means to step back, observe your life, and see it more clearly now and forever.
So we're back on public television for the 10th show that I have created, Pledge Show, to raise money for public television. A very, very favorite and important cause to me and my family of 8 children. The show that we are going to be watching tonight is called I Can See Clearly Now. And this is a book that has the same title, I Can See Clearly Now. But I remember listening to one of the great writers of all time, the great playwrights, Arthur Miller. And he once said, at the age of 91, when they were asking him, are you working on another play? He said, I don't know, but I probably am. And I really understood what he meant by that. It means being able to be open to divine guidance. I mean, I can see clearly now is a look at a tapestry that has been in my life from the time that I was a year and a half year old, when I was 12 years old, to when I was 18 years old, to 16 years old writing a novel, to when I was 19 years old in the Navy, writing every single day, to getting myself accepted at a university, all of that, never allowing myself to go with, it probably won't work out, or I'm afraid I'll fail, and so on. It's like our life was like a checkerboard, you know, and there's something bigger moving the checkers around in our life, and we think that we're in charge of all of it. Well, I was reading a book that was sent to me by a friend in England. It was written by Rashad Field. It was part of a trilogy, and it was the middle book of a trilogy. It was called To Know We Are Loved. And I was reading that book, and I came across about 4 lines that just intrigued me so much. I was reading them over and over and over again. And this is what they said. I made it the display quote for this book. It said, he was talking to someone who was very close to dying. And he said, if we stop for a moment, it is possible to perceive a pattern in our lives. The motivators that have influenced us become much more obvious. We are able to see life unfolding from both ends at once, coming into the present moment. But until we get to a certain point of realization, this is not possible. Because everything is still seen as a series of apparent causes and effects. That you have to be able to get to a place in your life where you can step back and realize that there are really two kinds of time. One of the kinds of time is what I call horizontal time, or cause and effect time, or the scientists call Cronus time, chronological time. This happens, and then this happens, and this causes this, and this is the cause and effect. And we have a tendency in our lives, as we look at all of the things that happen to us in our lives, to believe that everything has a cause and effect relationship. And so the reason that I am here today is because of all the things that I have done, all the choices that I have made, and they have led me to this place. But then there's another kind of time. And this is a kind of time that is called eternal time. And this is a line that doesn't go horizontal, it goes vertical. It goes straight up to our source of being, to the place that we come from. And this line is a kind of time that is deathless and is birthless and is eternal and it is always there. And when you get to a place in your life where you cross that line, when you see the place where horizontal time and vertical time cross, you have this realization that me, this personal me, this ego of mine, is not the thing that's making all of the choices, that there's something else that is involved. I called my publisher and I said to him, I want to step back. I want to step back from my life because I know that there have been forces or powers or some kind of energy that has been impacting me throughout my entire life. And I've been able to step back. And as it says in this quotation, it's so important to realize that it isn't, everything isn't just coming from the past. There are things that are coming from the future as well, that we're all always pulling out. It's like I just talked to someone who has a little baby. Little baby's just a few months old. And I said, do you realize that that little baby's wisdom teeth are already there? They're not going to come out of the past. They're already there. We're going to pull them out of the future. They're not going to show up for another 20 years or so, and that there are going to be choices to be made at that time. What do you do with them? Do you leave them in? Do you cut them out? All kinds of things. But there is this sense that not only is there a chronological cause and effect time taking place, but there's this eternal time in which everything about, for example, our entire physical being has already been handled for us. You know, it's like what your height is going to be and what the color of your skin is going to be, what the color of your eyes are going to be, and when your hair is going to fall out. I know the experience very well. So what I decided to do was to take a look at what were the circumstances and the people and the events and the things that kept showing up in my life, going all the way back to the time that I was just a little baby, all the way up to just recently, at the age of 73, which is the age I am now as we record this show. Something took a hold of me and said, write this. And I wrote, and I wrote, and I wrote, just because there was something that was pulling me in the direction of this is something that I absolutely had to do. And I started to realize that that's really the story of my entire life, and it's the story of all the rest of our lives as well. A great teacher of mine, his name was Carl Jung. He said, at the very same moment that you are a protagonist in your own life and you're making choices, he said, at the very same moment, you are also the spear carrier or an extra in a much, much larger drama. And then he said, you are all doomed to make choices. There's almost an awareness that there are no wrong roads to anywhere, that there's no accidents, that as we go along, there are course corrections that we can make, that every experience that we have in our life is there to teach us something. It's a very, very powerful awareness that yes, I'm making choices, but I'm also making choices within a context of everything is already laid out for me as well. I have to live with those two opposite points of view, if you will. And there are moments that come along in your life when you realize, yes, I'm making choices, but oh my God, there's also something else that is pulling me in this direction and is asking me to do that. And it's true of every single one of us, every single one of you that are watching. It's something that each and every one of us have. And every once in a while, you'll hit that quantum moment when your chronological time and your vertical line cross, and you realize, I have a choice to make. And you can either make that choice to follow and take that divine guidance that's come along and to look up that eternal plan. I just call it the eternal plan. This is, it's not really a memoir. It's really a compilation of the quantum moments that have taken place in my life. There was a great teacher of mine, a poet, who lived back in the 13th century. His name was Mevlana, which means our master, Jalaluddin Rumi, the great poet Rumi. And he said, when you are born, a ladder is placed before you to help you to escape from this world. All of us are here, we're in this world, filling out the forms, paying our taxes, and doing all the things that we do as physical beings, but we're really not of this world. Who we are, our true essence, isn't of this world. So I took a look at the rungs of this ladder and I put it together in five acts for this particular show. The first of these acts, the name of this act is the willingness to see clearly now.